This will be the finished product of your website. You will be given most of the HTML layout. One thing you will need to do is to configure the navigation according to industry standard. The navigation is coded in an unordered list. However, as you can see, it is nicely laid out across the page. Notice that when I put the cursor around the link, the whole area is clickable. You want to code the A elements to be block level elements using the display property so that the whole area is clickable. You will need to configure the navigation. You may use floats or you may use flexbox. Notice that we have two columns, a column on the left and a column on the right. The column on the right contains images that are stacked on top of each other. You will need to lay out these two columns so that they are side by side using the float property. Within the first column, you will need to lay out these two forms, which are inside a div container, using the float property. If you can accomplish this using Flexbox, you may. However, the float property will probably work better. So this is what you'll be starting with. Notice you're starting with an unordered list, so you will need to configure that properly. I have put the outline property on the two different areas. Our first column, which is actually the main element, is outlined in green. Notice that our forms are stacking up on top of each other. The right-hand column is actually an aside. The initial file, they will be all stacked on top of each other, and you will need to perform the layout. So on the left, we have the main element that should be set at a width of 720. On the right, we have the aside element, which should be set at a width of 240. The outer container is 960. Therefore, the values add up correctly. So you will need to lay out the navigation, the two main columns, and the two forms.